is actually a perfect person to complete the lecture series, precisely because I think he executes his work with such kind of unique attention to detail and such kind of clever and innovative ways of seeing through projects to reality. So it's a kind of a wonderful way to complete the series. But to introduce someone properly, Johan Laure is an architect, a co-founder of NAS Architecture, which is based in Montpellier, France. And the office's approach to architecture operates on a uniquely operates on a vast number of scales, and each with a same level of attention. Their projects investigate social expectations, urbanism, and functionality, with the ambition to engage as a key actor within local contexts. And this idea is really activated by the creation of interactive ecosystems, which you can see in the title, where buildings articulate new relationships between people and their surroundings. So among their super new office, and even in 2 short years, have managed to build an extraordinary number of projects and receive awards for their work, including a first place for the New Berlin Natural Science Museum Idea Competition, the Design and Innovation Ideas Prize for the Pavilion Bloom, and the public prize and jury prize for the breath box at the Lively Architecture Festival in Montpellier. And some of the people, some of the students here probably know him from his involvement in that same festival in Montpellier. I know a lot of Syracuse students here participated in that last summer in a process that John was a juror on. So anyway, we're very happy that he could be here.
Trying to combine all of the elements together to find another way to think about just separate things, thinking about global. So to express this concept, we mostly divide the interactive ecosystem into 5 categories. Very simple, so we have people. People are more about the needs, expectation, and it's about thinking about how to create daily circumstances for the social life, how to enhance the dynamic of the city by people. The program, we believe in heterogeneity of program, and we are always trying to begin from the program, the normal program, and to push it to the limit by listening to with the people, the context, and everything. The context, it's a key element for us. It's always a key element because we need to understand this context in order to fit to it or to be in contradiction with it. It's different posture, but we need to understand it in order to create something else. Sensoriality, so it's more about sensible approach, but it's more about putting humanity in project. Not just about 5 senses, but really put humanity in the program and in the context. And sustainability, it's more about a way of thinking this sustainability by the prism of temporality in project. Because different programs don't have the same temporality, and it's a way of thinking of how we can mix a different program to create a good temporality. So basically, all of these different categories, after we create some list of words that we put on it, depending on the project. And what is interesting is always to have rational words, like needs, use, security for people, but we have also subjective world. It's always interesting to put subjectivity in our project. So it depends on the categories. We have more or less subjectivity. For example, sensoriality is very subjective, right? Sustainability. We have a lot of rules in France about sustainability, but we are always trying to put common sense on it. It's not very easy, but sometimes it can work. And for example, regional heritage can be very useful, even if it's sometimes forgotten by a lot of people. So, after this kind of list, we try to just choose the very important words, the keywords of our project. In order not to resolve individually the problem, but more about trying to mix them like filters. And this permits to create interactive ecosystem. It's so related to scales and to subjectivity and objectivity about the project. So the goal is really to create a world that can contain a lot of the idea from the site, from the program, and from our program. So we always try to mix everything like this in very simple ways, understand the context, understand the problem, and match everything. So here's just a few of our projects in the office. So we have some built elements. So we began to work 2 years ago, so it's more like pavilions. In progress, it's more about public spaces, not public spaces, buildings, library or school in Montpellier. A lot of international competition and research. So here's a scale of the different projects. And for this lecture, I'll try to use different projects from different categories and different scales in order to explain the interactive ecosystem with different elements. So the first project is Bricebox in La Grande Motte in France. So it was for the Festival of the Architecture created by Jacques Guillaume and Elodie Nourgaard. So this was kind of a complicated project at the beginning because the city is quite impressive, created by Jean Ballalud. And it's a balnear city. And our spot was just this, and we have this bridge seafront. And it was quite complicated to imagine the good scale to put a pavilion on it. So in our idea of interactive ecosystem, we are trying to put, for example, three images at the time to contain all of the problematic of the site. For example, in this particular project, a big problem was the run. It's a lot of rain, and for the structure, it was a little tricky. So we have to think about the rain and how to import the landscape to our pavilion. And here we have the spot with this kind of concrete shape we have to think about. So we want to use this landscape in the pavilion. So we created little models of reflective elements that we can hang on the facade of the pavilion. So the main idea was to create a facade when the landscape can be reflected, but also disturbing by the wind itself. So the nature modifies the nature itself. That's quite interesting. So we create like a shelter of wood, of burned wood, on the site, and a facade of reflective elements on this site. So we try also to work with the landscape. This is Guillaume from NAS Architecture. And we began to build it, and we were quite afraid of the scaling because we have to make it together. So we construct this element of the pavilion. This is me, sorry. But I don't know if you try to burn me when it's raining, but it was quite and we have to put it on site. So we work with Bermud in order to create a very big contrast with the light when he passed through this room. It was amazing, but it's, and a lot of light on what is white, and we wanted to this something, and it tells the people of light on what. So it was great. So this is a bridge box. We're training also with this elements, concrete elements that I talked to you just before, to recreate this kind of rhythm on it, but with a different materiality. So it's like a kind of duality in this project, because you have the inside, which you can see the sea now, and you just see the reflection of yourself when you go through it. So you can see the different light effects, and it was quite interesting because we have 2 or 3 degrees less from the outside, so a lot of people come to this pavilion just in order to be cool. So on the outside you have the landscape which reflects to this, this pavilion, and the wind come and make move all of these different elements in order to or the kids they can. And it was quite interesting to see the landscape in a different way. So you can see it here. Inside. And I will give this was broken, sorry. So that's it. This is a competition we made architect, interior competition in Cap de Nac in France. So it was a landscape really with a lot of vegetation and very mineral landscape with a lot of little villages. And we have to think about a way of introducing a technological program in something more rural. So the challenge was to think about integrating the program in the field, and we are always thinking about the linearity of the village that surrounds the project. So first of all, this is the site. This is the volume of the project. It's not even the half of the site. So this is the program, and we decide to put the other way to create individual elements in order to continue this view from the both side of the site, and we fit it to the topography. So, and we wanted to integrate the landscape to the project for 2 reasons. One for the light, it's like big elements and mid light, and for the temperature to create using, like we say, pasture. It's something we used a lot in the south of France, and now we continue, but we wanted to share this common element to everybody. So we have the different access and the parking, and we wanted to use the landscape in order to hide them and create like a continuous landscape of the program. We can use the different pathway now for the visitors and the workers. And we create the landscape. So this is the project. There seems to be individual, but they are really linked on the background. And we can we have the different view to the project. We imagine it like a campus. And we work on the facade of the project using the minerality and the different elements that we thought was interesting in the site. So it's more about topography project. It was really complicated to fit out the elements of the program in the topography, and we have to think about elements in order to give access to structure or something like it. And what's interesting when a medieval city, and we have the choice to put the pavilion anywhere. So we were thinking about the interesting limits that creates this this rampart between the city and what's it outside, and we didn't choose the easy way, but we wanted to create the pavilion on the rampart to fit to it. So we were thinking about the Middle Ages construction. We were obliged to be with wood, and we were thinking about the light, how to introduce the light in this kind of pavilion. So we made some research about Middle Ages construction, and we wanted to use the same structure in order to provide a historic historic idea of the project. So it's a contemporary vision, but with historic basis. So we use a negative shape. So we create the shape, and we cut the different arches in order to create like a vortex. And so we have 10 arches. And we create this kind of vortex, and we change the scale of the pathway of the rampart. So this is the section, and this is a photography of the project at the end. But it begins with something more like this, more complicated. So we have to build it. This is Guillaume and Hadrien near the wall. The first build of the project, quite proud. And we have to fix. It's quite funny because he worked on the wrong part, like it was a night watch of the Game of Thrones, you know. And but what's funny is he had vertigo, so he always very straight on this foot. It was quite a hard work for him. Right. So we finished to build it, and it was quite a big challenge for us. We create like a tunnel, a new vortex for everybody. We don't have roof on the rampart, so with this kind of pavilion, we create something really different. Really, we change the scale of the pathway. So we use a laser cut in order to have this kind of shape, and we really want to end this project without knowing really how the project is ending. We don't really see the structure. We just see the roof. So we have the vortex here. Yeah. And we have from the from the inside and from the city. So when the night is coming, we have a different vision of the city and the materiality of the streets. And it was quite interesting that during the day it's really in contrast with the rampart. And during the night, the sunset, he begins to fit with his environment. Quite interesting as this sunset. So this is a competition that we won about national branding, about natural science in Berlin. So the context was quite complicated too, because we have a highway here, we have a zoo here, because it's a car, so it's a zoo. And the main site was on this plot. So it's parking. And what we were thinking about is the park, the topography of the park, how to fit to a museum, and also a small subjective view of the museum. We're thinking it about a cave. So in order to mix all these elements, we're trying to create like a layer, really. We have the cave on the underground. It's a museum. We have the home for people with research, education, and from the outside of the building and go in between the museum. So this was in order to create some different spaces, something more rational, something more different feel on the outside. So this is the site, and we begin by digging the soil in order to create this, this kind of shape, like a natural cave for the museum. We put the park on it, and after we have the home, but it's in order to continue the urban shape of Berlin, not to be too too aggressive with this museum. So when finished, it seems to be quite quite easy in the city, but when we go through the taxonometry, we understand that this is a museum, so with a lot of different spaces, amphitheater, and we wanted something very the flow can be very very great and like an exploratory of the museum. Donc, something that remains a cave, so we're trying to be monolithic, and you can see the entrance here. On the first floor, we have so the landscape, and we have the park with the topography that continues through the building, and this permits to create different spaces on it and to create a continuity to break the different limits of the museum. And working with transparency on the first floor and to be more homogeneous on the second and third floor. So floor, the second floor is about the research center, and the only organic shape is this access. So from the landscape, from the first floor to the research center, and we can create some spaces like it, so we can see the different landscape and the continuity of the entrance. And this is the school. So in section it's quite clear that the ground begins to interact with the underground museum and this kind of spaces. And can create entrance, can create amphitheater, and can be directly linked for this level. So this is a pavilion for Festival of 3D Architecture. This time it was this year. And we have to build the main pavilion, the information pavilion. And it was quite complicated to put a pavilion to a courtyard such beautiful and such historical courtyard. So we have to think about these columns, the big elements of the courtyard, to think about welcoming people. So it's the program, the main program. And we wanted to put something more informal, so, something more different to have the formal way of welcoming people and another way, more free. So we search a lot about the shape we were not really sure. And we finish with this kind of shape. This allows to have an informal meeting structure just here and a more formal structure here. So the roof becomes the ground, and the ground becomes the roof, and you can pass through this space, and you can sit on it in order to meet the people, to discuss about the festival, to read the book about the festival. So we really want to make the same pavilion, but with different way of welcoming people. So this is the elevation, it's quite different, you can see, but when we put it together, we create a pavilion with two different colors too. We have the white for the welcoming, and we talk about the scenography. And you have the black, it's black wood, used mostly in the apartment or some hotel. But this permit to create maybe a different scale to the project and to work with kind of column. The pavilion is wrapping around it, and we create like a view and different spaces to it. So what was interesting is this kind of photography when you have people on the pavilion and also inside, so it works differently, but in the same time. So it was quite disturbing for some people because it's transparent, but the transparency inside, but also sometimes it's really strict and with a little space. So this stairs was really used a lot by people. It was about people coming to eat, to play guitar, to make fashion show also. But also about kids, about class group. We were a little afraid about this kind of points on it, but it worked, so it's fine. You don't have to pay for anything. And so bigger kids can see maybe some people that you know. And it was quite interesting because we really wanted to create something that fit to the program and people that can use it in their own way. So we are quite proud of it. From that library, this is a building that we progress, so we begin to build soon. The site was quite new when we began, because it's just a neighborhood with a lot of little houses. So to put a public building on it is always quite complicated about the scale, about a lot of things. So we didn't want to be too in the contrary to the context. We wanted to try to fit to this kind of neighborhood, even if it's not the same scale, not the same problem. So we say, okay, trying to fit with it. So we work with a different roof and this kind of shape, very simple, but we wanted to fit. And always a subjective element, we always thinking about an attic with a roof, and we wanted to try to create a kind of space like this. So basically, we take the roof and we create the shape of the building. But we have to think about how to express this roof in plan or in section. It's not that simple. So we work on the different different sides of the of roof, different position. So the main idea, the final idea, was to use the roof, but to rotate them in order to give to this public building another identity, something a certain landmark, but not too much in order to fit with the identity of the neighbor. So this is the master plan of the project, so to create this kind of landscape too. So this is the project. We work with something very monolithic, like a pixel windows. And we wanted to create a building very free space. So with a big entrance, we have a big patio at the end of the building and create a very simple space. So what's it's interesting with the roof is that we create a lot of different spaces with a different geometry just by adding roof, but diagonal roof, but roof. And we create about proportion, about patio and entrance. So we create this kind of space. We can't really see that they are in diagonal, so at the end it will be really interesting, this kind of volume. And mark them on the facade. So we work with stones, like striped stones that go through a lot of different senses in order to mark the facade. So this is the project at the end. The last pavilion room. So we made the design and innovative idea work about it. We were the only architect to do this competition. It's more like a landscape competition, it's a garden competition. So it was quite a challenge for us too. This is the castle of Chaumont-sur-Loire. So it's a big castle, but with a bigger garden, and they create a festival out of the year in the garden here. And so they made an international competition, and we were selected, and we were lucky because the only site with a view to the war was our site, so we were quite excited. And we think about the garden, okay, but we wanted to add something very to let people meet during this this festival. So we think about a banquet for the United States banquet. We have to put the garden and the banquet together in order to create something really interesting for the visitors. So basically, this is our site. This is the garden, and we put the table around the garden. So this is a diagram. The people from Chaumont was quite fine by this, because most of the time the garden is out of the site. But in this project, the garden is only in the center of the project, and you can't go to it. So they don't really know how to accept that, but they say, okay, we want to try it. So we have to work with a very neutral situation in the outside surrounding, and something very dynamic and with a lot of volume on the inside. So we wanted to create something very simple, very very white, very very simple, with something more dynamic on the inside and with a lot of color. So this is the model. So we work during one week on it, with fog, with everything, with rain, but at the end we create room. And we wanted to have the structure hidden by the ground, because it seems that we just put the table on the ground, but we have like 1 meter of foundation on the ground. But, we wanted to make something very simple, very white, and the garden need to be very intense on the center. And you can see the view to the Loire, and we walk on the right head in order to view to see the view outside. So you have to walk around this table in order to see everything. This is the photography from the first day. So the plants, the vegetation is very small, but after 2 months, you can see this kind of topography. You just see a wave of flora. So it's interesting to work with vegetation, because it evolves during the year, and you have a different vision of the project. So kids begin to keep drawing, to use it, to... So this is the work, and you can see the height of the table. So we work on this kind of shape with our knee. We create it by our way, but it's fine. I hope kids are doing a lot of brainstorming on this table. Prepare for the future. So people have to move around in order to take pictures of the different vegetation. And you can see the perspective to the work with the project. We choose just some project and put light on it. So they quite understand the concept of red in the project, I think. Maybe a little different, but it was quite funny to see the project like this. And it was funny too because we see our project in a, it's a very famous show in France, and they use it to present the show. So, and you can see the flowers, you know, they are very tall. So it's quite, it was quite funny. House of reality, so this is a competition for the SCP urban design competition. So we work on it and we try to make a concept as we want to show. So this is a site, so with the park, the port, and all of the roof of the city. And we choose three different images, one for the roof, because we talk about the roof of the city, one from the park, and one from the port, because the port is in the element of the port. So basically, we wanted to create a house on trees. It's kind of our imagination, but we wanted to have some space like this to create, use the tree, continue the park to the museum, and created a museum on the tree. So we begin to link all of the elements of the site. We have the program, yeah. And we really wanted to create it's a private space, but like a public space. So we linked it to the ground on the outside, and we put the museum on it. And the roof. This kind of roof, more like intelligent roof. We wanted to use this kind of shape in order to protect some spaces just under this roof, and to have the renewable water and solar system on it. So it fit to the museum by creating energy and water for the museum. So this is a museum, you can easily see the first layer, it's like more about the lobby, the restaurant. People can go freely through this space. You have the museum, which is more silent, more intimate for the people. And you have the different roof that can protect the spaces of the museum. So you have the different restaurants, you have the lobby, you have the hall, the amphitheater on the first floor, and those spaces that can allow the production of art on the main side of the restaurant. And you have some protective space like this to the box in order to continue the museum on the outside. Also. And you can see the tree that can. The structural to the roof, and everything is wood. The museum space with a tree coming from the ground to the roof and passing through the different spaces, also with smaller spaces. And for the roof, you can have some spaces like this, so protected from the different from the water, from the rain, and also creating different view to the landscape. So this is the principle for our roof, the wood construction, and a renewable water cycle. Yeah. So this is a resource with a solar system. And this is a project for in order to continue the different roof of SMP. And the last project is about artifact nature. So this is a research project for LED. LED is a factory that creates energy with oxygen. So it's not very seductive for the clients, this kind of image. landscape. So they really want to create something else. So we have to think about a non-landscape, because we don't have context, we don't have sight, but we know that it's obliged to fit to a lot of different sites. So we think about the different mountain, about the protection, about the light, about a lot of things that can help us to think about this envelope. So basically we create like an intelligent envelope that can protect from the acoustic. It's a lot of sound on the inside. So protect from the acoustic, protect from the difference of temperature, depending on the inside and outside. And also they can fit to the surrounding. So to imagine how to use the surrounding to introduce the building to it. So we were thinking about a skin, intelligent skin on it, in order to prevent the different problems of the landscape. So solar protection, but also acoustic protection, and for the temperature too, the weather. And so this is the project. It's about reflective panels. It was not a question of raising all of the factory, but also we wanted to create a way of adapting to all of the different landscape. So the basic idea was to create something that can react to the different landscape that it's put. So we create stripes like this, and that can fit to a lot of different landscape. And we can use it to add some different panels that can protect from the acoustic, from the weather, and different things depending on the landscape. So this is a project, quite big scale too. So it has to fit with a different landscape. This is a section, so it's an envelope on the all of the factory, and you can adapt to the different situation of the landscape. We have three different places. We have the factory, we have the envelope, and we have a space on it that can help visitors to see the landscape from it. Create a new place for visitors. So this project can fit with the snow too, because we can protect it with different panels inside of the factory, make it very simple with different view, different sort of very simple too, because we can't move all of these different elements. It was really rational, so it was more about thinking about this envelope. And for the visitors, we create a landmark that can fit to all of the different landscape. And at the end, the project itself can fit to the, we hope, to all of the different landscape. Thank you. We think about the way of fitting the program in something else. So we we always try to put different subjective elements. So we try, sometimes it didn't work, so we come back to the main idea, the principal idea. But the subjectivity is the same for sustainability. It just not creates something too functional. It just to be functional, but you have to put what we think about it, what we can just feel about the project, and trying to mix it with the objective element, just in order to create something that can fit maybe sometimes well with the problem and the site. But it's not something that maybe you can make the project different, you know. But it was just our personal view of it. We call it subjective because it's quite subjective. But it's more about our feeling, or more about the discussion with the people about a lot of things. It's just, like I said before, a list of things. And after we try to put them together, we just try to match them. And we can see if it works or if it not works. But just not to be too rational. We need to be a little subjective, just in order to sometimes just to be fun sometimes. But,
thanks for that. It's really interesting work. You presented everything very linearly, like very procedurally, I guess I would say. And I see a specific method in the way that you're working. I'm wondering if you ever break away from that method, where you know that the image to the subjective versus the objective terms, and then the program and everything. And does that, have you learned anything from the previous projects that you kind of cycle into the next project?
We learn mostly a lot about different projects we made, and sometimes we can see different connection about some project. For example, this one with police box, it was a reflective facade. This one was before police box, and we were always thinking about it when we made the pavilion. And for the technique of thinking, it's more about a tool. Sometimes we don't have a lot of time to think about projects, and this kind of thinking permits us to be really effective. It's more about, because we work a lot together, before we meet the office, during 5 years during school, and during these years we created a way of working, because we work in the school, but also in a student competition, and also in the office. So it was a lot of things, and we need to be really efficient and really clear. It's not, maybe it's not always the best answer that what we create, but it's something that can, we can fit to the project, and we try to put everything we can to it. So it's more like a tool, a process, but it's not as simple and as linear as I presented. Sometimes it's very messy, and it ended up we didn't know if we can make the project or not, but it's not that linear and that simple, but we always try to be the more strict on it possible, because we want it to be really effective.
Building around a column.
Yeah.
I was wondering, can you walk beyond the steps?
Right.
Can you definitely
sometimes it's just not the programs that interest us, it's more about the sites. Because, for example, in the first second project, Laboratories, the program was quite interesting, but not that much. But the site was really impressive, really interesting. So, for programs, most of the time, sure, it can be something that can let us really free, so like the library or like a museum. But we worked on dwelling housing this time in the office. It is really, really interesting. It's less just architecture. It's also finding a way to make people live together. And sometimes it's way more interesting than just big spaces and big geometry. So it depends on the